Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the first in a series of Click Philosophy debates where profound questions in philosophy will be answered with discussions between philosophers throughout history. The question that the first debate will deal with is, does God exist? This question has been pondered ever since the emergence of religion and is notorious even in the modern world, where it helps create epic wars in YouTube comment sections. This may be because it is difficult to reconcile faith used by many religions to assert the existence of God with reason and logic. However, some philosophers throughout history have attempted to prove the existence of God through reason, and tonight we'll consult Saint Thomas Aquinas about his cosmological argument and pit it against the ideas of Carl Sagan. Using a highly capable time machine invented by Click Philosophy, we have brought them to our debate table. But before we begin, let's agree on the definition of God that'll be used throughout the debate. The definition of God is as follows: a being that is all-powerful, all-knowing, and all-good. To begin the debate, Saint Aquinas, who is for the existence of God, will now present his cosmological argument. The cosmological argument, which I presented in my book Summa Theologica, is concerned with the existence of God as necessary given the chain of causes and effects going on in the universe. My argument goes like this: everything that we see in the universe right now, for example, the ball dropping when I release it, me walking, the sun shining, has a cause. Each of those causes have a cause of their own, and so on. However, there cannot be a chain of causes that extend forever into infinity. Something must have begun the chain of events that produce the effects that we see today. That something, which we call the first cause, did not need to have been caused and would have been extremely powerful. The first cause, by definition, is likely to have been God. So, in a nutshell, something really powerful, who is God, must have existed in order to have set off the chain of motion that produced the phenomena that we see today. Dr. Sagan?
Well, firstly, I think the cosmological argument is extremely interesting because it is something that we cosmologists and physicists are investigating, except that the focus, as well as the research, is based upon the scientific method. Scientists generally agree that the Big Bang, which itself is a misnomer of some sort, was the moment when the universe was created. However, there are certain objections I have to make in response to your argument. Firstly, if we were to agree that something very powerful must have set off the chain of motion for the universe, then there is an undeniable possibility that something other than God could have caused it. After all, to have caused a chain of motion in the universe, one needs only to be very powerful, not all good or all knowing, the latter two which are essential to the definition of God. If we were to accept the suggestion that God has created the universe, then we would have to answer another question. Where did God come from? If this is an unanswerable question, then why not skip a step and suggest that the origin of the universe is an unanswerable question? If we say that God has always existed, why not skip a step and say that the universe has always existed without need for being created? How do we know that there could not have been an infinite chain of causes and effects, and the universe had no beginning at all, and that the Big Bang was yet another rapid inflation following a massive deflation of a previous universe? These are not easy questions. Occam's razor, a method of deciding between two explanations, suggests that the explanation with fewer number of assumptions is more likely to be correct. There is no particular need for the existence of a deity to explain the cause of the universe if we cannot explain the cause of the deity. It would be adding more assumptions and raises more questions than it answers compared to the alternative. But all in all, regardless of whichever conclusion we might get to, there is no reason to fight over this question. I'm looking at you, Internet. It is important to cultivate understanding of different religions and perspectives, and better yet, to realize that as a small, insignificant species tucked away in some distant corner of the galaxy, we only have each other to hold onto, and most importantly, we should prevent ourselves from engaging in self-harm or self-destruction over such matters.
And the time is up! Which side wins? You decide! Comment your thoughts below, but please keep it to the specific debate.
Oh, and ClickPhilosophy recently passed its 1,000 subscriber milestone. I would like to give a big thank you to everyone who supported ClickPhilosophy by viewing, liking, and subscribing. If you haven't done so already, please subscribe for more awesome videos.